Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Nahmadu wa nasta'inuhu wa nasta'afiruhu Wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina min sayyiati a'malina
Man yahdillahu fala mudilla lah Wa man yudlil fala hadiya lah
Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah Wa ashhadu anna sayyidana Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluhu La nabiyya ba'dah Allahumma fasalli wa sallim wa barik ala sayyidina Muhammad Wa ala alihi wa sahbihi Wa man tabi'ahu bi ihsan ila yawmil qiyamah Amma ba'du fa ya ibadallah Usikum wa nafsi bi taqwallah Faqad faza al-muttaqun يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم وهو أصدق القائلين أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم نحن قسمنا بينهم معيشتهم في الحياة الدنيا ورفعنا بعضهم فوق بعض الدرجات ليتخذ بعضهم بعضا سخريا ورحمة الله ورحمة ربك خير مما يجمعون صدق الله العظيم Ma'asyar al-hadirin, dear brothers, rahimahumullah. First and foremost, all praise belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. God who gives mercy. It is because of the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we can enjoy the independence of our nation. We live an independent, sovereign, safe, and peaceful country so that we can carry out our respective duties as the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secondly, we extend our prayers and greetings to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He gave us instructions and examples on how to liberate humans and live as free human beings based on monotheism. Tawheed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brothers, in this precious occasion, I would like to also remind myself and all of you to maintain and improve our obedience, our taqwa to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our obedience and submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are manifestations of our faith to Allah the Almighty. Wa'ashir wa hadirin, dear brothers, rahimakumullah. Tomorrow, August 17, 2024, tomorrow will be the commemoration of the 78th anniversary of the Republic of Indonesia. This is not a short and fast time, but rather a long journey of a nation that freed itself from the shackles of colonialism. We not only commemorate its history, but also enjoy the freedom. In this occasion, I would like to invite all of you to reminisce a little about the proclamation of the independence of Indonesia in 1945, when the founding fathers of the nation spoke loudly and confidently, declared the independence of Indonesia as a nation blessed with diverse ethnicities, beliefs, cultures, and natural resources. MashaAllah Khadirin, dear brothers, there are three important things that become common capital of our nation's founding fathers in fighting for independence. The first is the spirit to become an independent nation. Our founding fathers, our predecessors, experienced the pain of living under the control of other nations. They cannot have their own ideals and cannot determine the fate of their own nation. The spirit to become an independent nation is the spirit to have one's own national vision, the spirit to determine the fate and one's own nation, and the spirit to achieve prosperity and well-being for the entire nation fairly and equally. We have to preserve this spirit in maintaining our independence. We must continue to become an independent nation, a nation that determines its own destiny, a nation that has great aspirations for the prosperity and welfare for its people. For this reason, we must prepare superior, competitive, and moral human resources. We have continuously improved the quality of our human resources through excellent education. MashaAllah hadirin, dear brothers, rahimakumullah. The second spirit is the spirit of togetherness in diversity. The spirit is the spirit of finding common ground in togetherness and not exaggerating differences. With this spirit, the nation's founding fathers put aside differences of ethnicity, differences of faith, race, languages, and culture. They celebrated the spirit of togetherness to become one common nation, that is Indonesia. We need to preserve this spirit amidst the increasingly diverse Indonesian nation. Only with the spirit of unity and diversity can we maintain the unity of Indonesia as one nation, and we can continuously work together for the future of our nation. MashaAllah hadirin, dear brothers in Islam, rahimakumullah. The third spirit is the spirit of belief in Allah's grace, in God's grace. Despite different beliefs, the founding fathers of the nation had a strong belief in God. They believe that God gives His blessing to people who are willing to strive for the progress of their own nation. Inna Allaha la yughayyiru ma biqaumin hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusihim. The ulama who took part in the struggle to gain and maintain the independence made Islam the main inspiration to fight the invaders. Therefore, they believe that independence was obtained not solely because of their struggle, but more importantly, because of Allah's grace, which accompanies those who struggle and try their best. Belief in God's grace makes us have strong spirit and high self-confidence. This belief becomes a great force that can drive the way we do the best things we can do. Confidence in Allah's grace can set us free from dependence on other nations, and also make us free from being arrogant and overly proud of ourselves. MashaAllah hadirin, dear brothers in Islam, by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are lucky to be able to inherit a safe and peaceful country, a country with abundant natural resources, a country that is beautiful and comfortable for us to live in. There is no other beautiful, comfortable, and rich country than Indonesia. Therefore, it is our duty to maintain the beauty, the comfort, and the peace of this nation by continuing to preserve nature and maintain good relations between human beings. We are also tasked with managing this nation as well as possible, so that it can become a superior nation, a nation that is respected by the world, and able to become a pioneer in the civilization of other nations in the world, in the midst of a destructive world. MashaAllah hadirin, dear brothers in Islam, let us ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give Indonesian nation a trustworthy leader, a leader that prioritizes the interests of the nation above the interests of group and individual. A leader who paid more attention to the welfare and well-being of his people, and not only the welfare and well-being of himself and his group. A leader who entrusts the professional to take part in managing this nation and country so that they are able to lead this nation towards progress and superior among other nations. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all, bless our leaders, and to continue to bless our beloved country. A'udhu billahi minasyaitanir rajim, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ya ayyuhalladzina amantakullaha qatqatih, wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Barakallahu li wa lakum bil Qur'anil 'azhim wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bima fihi min al-ayati wa dhikri hakim. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah al-'azhim wa li wa lakum wa li sa'ir al-muslimina fastaghfiruh innahu huwal ghafurur rahim.
Untuk ikut mengelola bangsa dan negara ini
sehingga mampu mengantarkan bangsa ini menuju pada kemajuan. Ayuhal ikhwah, i'lamu anna Allah amarakum bi amrin bada'a fihi bi nafsi wa thanna bi malaikatihi musabbihati bi qudsi fa qala ta'ala wa lam yazal qa'ila halima inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'alan nabi ya ayyuhalladzina amanu sallu 'alaihi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina Muhammad kama sallaita ala sayyidina Ibrahim wa ala ali sayyidina Ibrahim wa barik ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina Muhammad kama barakta ala sayyidina Ibrahim wa ala ali sayyidina Ibrahim fil alamin innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un qaribun mujibud da'awat ya qadhiyal hajat wa ya kafiyal hikmat. اللهم ادفع عنا البلاء والغلاء والوباء والفحشاء والمنكر والبغي والسيوف المختلفة والشدائد والمحن ما ظهر منها وما بطن من بلدنا هذا خاصة ومن بلدان المسلمين عامة إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم أنت ربنا ونحن عبادك بنو عبيدك وإمائك نعبدك لا إله إلا أنت فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله عظيم الذكر واشكروه.